We're Andrew and Kate. We share travel tips to help you see the world and have the best vacations ever. If you daydream about traveling to sunny Italy as much as we do, keep watching to check out the best things to do in Positano on the Amalfi Coast. Good morning from the Amalfi Coast. We are in Positano and we're about to have a relaxing beach day, but first we've got to trek down to the beach, and so we're going to show you how to get there and what to expect with Italian beaches. We walked 300 stairs down to the beach, and yes, 300 stairs is not an exaggeration, but we finally made it. Last night I booked our chairs online, and I'll leave that link down below of where to go. You can choose between first row or any other row. First row is a little bit more, but you are first access to the beach and have a straight view without anybody being in your way. So that's about $30 a chair, but you have to buy them in a set of two. So that comes with both me and Andrew for a set for $63 after online fees. Also attached to the umbrella is a QR code that you can order all the food and drinks you want. It's early and we haven't had coffee yet, and it is past time, so I ordered both of us an espresso and a liter of water to get us started for the day. I'm sure we'll be in the water in no time, but in the meantime, we're just gonna relax and sip on our espresso. As soon as I said espresso, it was like a magic word. And they gave to bring the drinks. So here's our little espressos from their little local bar. Yum. Bar in Italian doesn't just mean the American version of bar, it's essentially coffee bar or breakfast bar. You just fill up, get a shot of espresso, and pay for it, walk out, call it a day. So that's pretty much the coffee culture in Italy. Beach time with some morning espresso brought directly towards us. I'd say this is a great coffee with a view. Little espresso cup.
Let's get in the water.
Rocky beaches and freezing water. That is beautiful. At some point today, I'll get fully in. I can't commit to it right now. I don't warm up first or wait till the sun gets higher, so I need to cool off. I'm just not hot enough just yet. But I still cannot get over these peaks of houses. What a view. This is what you come for. It's about lunchtime, it's noon, I'm getting a little hungry. I'm just gonna use the QR code again to order some food to be brought here. We're gonna split a pizza and a spritz. Our total is 26, and the most convenient thing is you can just pay with Apple Pay. You don't have to worry about paying with euros or exchanging money. You just use what's on your phone, and it's on its way.
Grazie. Grazie.
A beautiful margherita pizza delivered to us. I don't think anything could be more perfect.
Pizza with a view.
Wow.
Okay, so we've gotten cleaned up after a relaxing morning at the beach, and we're about to head out to meet our Airbnb experience boat tour. Let's head out. We walked down the set of 400 stairs again towards the marina to meet our boat captain and tour guide, along with four other travelers, for our four-hour tour of the Amalfi Coast. This Airbnb experience featured the beautiful ship itself, some veggie snacks freshly picked from the captain's mom's garden, a few fun facts about the coastline, and time to swim. You did it! As the water was so cold, the boys chose to not keep swimming after jumping in. With the extra time, we stopped into the namesake of the coast, the town of Amalfi. We scoped out the must-see churches and pathways of the port and enjoyed a classic Italian snack of Fritto Misto, which is a cone of mixed fried seafood, along with gelato and, of course, Amalfi lemon sorbetto. After our shore excursion, we hopped back on the boat, celebrated our travels with Prosecco, and headed back towards Positano.
Cheers, guys.
We're gonna head to dinner.
Yes.
There is so many great restaurants here. I mean, every single corner, you've got a great restaurant.
There's several Michelin stars, and I'm gonna be honest, this trip was quite last minute, so I don't actually have any reservations for tonight, so we're just gonna see what happens, mm-hmm. walk around. A lot of times, there'll be people trying to like get you to come in because Americans tend to eat much earlier than Italians,
yes.
and so that doesn't take up the table for us mm-hmm. long, and it's 7 o'clock and we're starving because mm-hmm. we're grandparents that normally eat at 5:30.
Yeah. So we're holding so off, but
we're holding
it's gonna
off.
Be great.
Hopefully she'll get a table. This is beautiful. It is still crazy to be walking on the side of the road. This is the road where cars are driving by every 3 seconds, but this is the view. Ordered our spritzes drink. I don't know what the plural of spritz are. what spritz is?
Spritzes?
Spritzes?
I think that's right.
I don't know what the plural of spritz is besides spritzes, but I think we're going to both get our own pasta and then split a meat dip. Ristorante Bruno, and we do talk about Bruno because this looks amazing. Little Disney reference for you. We don't talk about Bruno. And now it's gonna be stuck in my head all night, so sorry. But I got the basically seafood gnocchi, which came with bread, and Andrew got the carbonara, which looks spectacular. I've never seen gnocchi served like this. That's like salty and seafoody and heavenly. Tomatoes inside of the mussels are smoking hot.
Before I eat this carbonara, which is a very Roman dish, so like in Rome you get carbonara, that's the thing you do. It's actually a World War II's like creation of food because they had rations around that time where ham and egg and all these different things were mixed together, and they made this carbonara dish that became kind of the staple in Rome. So it's amazing and I love it. Every time we come to Italy, I get it. And I'm sure I'm gonna have it more in Rome when we go there in a few days. Good al dente. Good little bite on it. Good bacon. Quality stuff.
As soon as we finished our individual pastas, we split the shrimp, which is like the main dish, which normally you'd have what is it called? An antipasti, like an appetizer, and then you'd have your like pasta dish, and then a main dish, and then a dessert, and a coffee, and then digestivo. But we can't eat that much. We just finished dinner, and now we're gonna keep walking down the street to keep walking, keep shopping, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Big deal here is a lot of like leather-made shoes. You can actually get custom leather sandals for less than 70 euros in a lot of places in Positano. Look how beautiful.
Pretty much the nightlife here is shopping, gelato, and dinner.
Not bad.
Not bad. I'm okay with it. And it's beautiful, and just to be able to sit at dinner and enjoy the sunset is just what you do, and it's the best. We could stay here every single night and watch that sunset.
Okay, for all that have seen our Christmas vlogs, we love Christmas and a Christmas market. Look at this living nativity. We have to get a little Positano Christmas. Limonada. It smells so good. I think it is a fair assessment to say Positano and the Amalfi Coast is definitely a place where Americans like to go for obvious reasons. It's beautiful, it's scenic, it has so much to offer. It also feels very much like a place Americans want to go. But I tell you, I hear more American accents than people speaking Italian. I don't love it. It's not why I come to Italy. I want to come to Italy for Italian culture and things. And this is clearly a place that does cater towards international tourism, which is great because it's beautiful and I understand why. but it doesn't feel quite as Italian as other destinations, I'd say. Just my 2 cents over gelato. Gelato is so fabulous. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the next locations in our Italian adventures. Ciao!